Hi everybody, welcome to another podcast by another day. This is number
six.
I was almost gonna do seven.
I had to check the notes.
Yes, and it's April 7th.
Can you believe it?
And we're having another horrible rainy day, although the sun's starting to come out. So Thursdays, rain and snow and ice. So
every Thursday has been gloomy and bad lighting. And
yeah, but such is life in the spring, in Canada.
Even though there's snow outside,
it's spring.
Yeah. So how was your week?
Good.
Yeah?
Good. I went on a field trip. Well, actually, immediately after we finished recording last week's episode, I went on a field trip. I wrote down on our little note, I'm like, I gotta go.
If you notice that at the very end, I'm talking and all of a sudden my eyes start down and I'm frantic. Like, and have a good week, guys.
I had to go to field trip in the pouring rain outside. But it was fun. The kids are really good about it. And they made the most delicious granola bars.
You guys make granola bars?
The kids made them and then brought them and we had them as a snack.
Nice. I went on the same field trip, different class, and we did not get granola bars. We had to tromp through the snow, but it was better than rain. But it had fresh snow and ice and it was a lot of fun. But oh my God, I was so tired by the end of the day.
You guys went all day.
All day. Yeah, we left at 8:30 in the morning and we got back at a little bit after 2.
Yeah.
So, I mean, all day for grade two. So it was a lot of fun, but holy cannoli was I tired.
One of my older boys is on that field trip today. He's gone all day today.
I think he's going to sleep well tonight, or they just have so much energy. Yeah, I don't know.
Sleeping, what's that?
Yeah.
My oldest went to bed at 10 o'clock last night, and he woke me up at 6:30.
Mm-mm. My kids need snooze buttons.
Not happy.
Snooze buttons, and we need a divider in our cars. So car companies, we want that limo divider.
Yes.
Yeah. Robbie and I were talking about this last night while we were driving. Because we have a minivan, but three kids. So one sits in the middle. Loser cruiser. Love it. Totally own loser cruiser. One sits in the middle and two sit in the back. And I was like, wouldn't it be great if all three sat in the back and then we could just like build like a barricade wall. Mm-hmm. And oh yeah, we went there. And then he put on his tool belt to build it for me. Speaking of tool belt, I will get you pictures.
Joanne,
I've got tool belt pictures and we're going to insert it maybe right there.
We won't tell him preemptively.
I almost thought like maybe today I'd show up at like his construction site and just be like
I totally should, that might be a little creepy, honey, I brought you lunch.
I totally should. Oh my God, that'd be so much fun. But he'd laugh. I told him that you guys were actually talking about it and I thought his like chest kind of puffed out. He's like, oh yeah. And I'm like, oh honey, it's all good. So
you know tool belt. No, we forgot.
What did we forget?
I'm Christina. I am the cozy knitter. And you can find me online on Ravelry and Instagram as the cozy knitter.
Yeah. And I'm Amanda. I'm a yarn enabler on Instagram and Facebook. And I'm the yarn enabler on Ravelry because I was late to the game and there's already a yarn enabler. And I hope she doesn't get a whole bunch of messages that are meant for me. Sorry.
She probably has. What's going on?
She's never contacted me, so I have to wonder. But she, actually, I've looked her up because I accidentally like looked for myself.
I've tagged her before when I tried to tag you. And then I'm like, so right, that changes.
Yeah, she owns a yarn store and she's big into like, I know, right? That makes sense for the username, but I don't know. So I've never talked to her, but I'm assuming she's That's a nice person. Funny. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, anywho.
So, I think we should do some thank yous.
Yes.
So first off, I gotta say thank you to Sue. Sue and Chelsea of Legacy Knits. They had a really nice podcast this week. Yeah. It was a bit longer than their normal ones, but they were off the week before.
Which was even better. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I need something long sometimes. When I'm sitting and I've got hours of winding, I don't want a 30-minute boom. I want to sit and like really have a visit. So
yeah,
it was nice
depends
for me.
It depends on what I'm doing, but it was nice for her. And I was laughing because Sue was talking about how she feels like she's connected with us. And we can totally be besties, Sue. That's no problem at all.
There's enough of me to go around. We can still all be besties.
I don't have
to have just the sock setter, my best friend, and my best friend. I can do you too. I can be best friend.
That took an odd turn now, didn't it?
Belts on the brain.
Oh my goodness.
We're gonna have to rate this like R on YouTube. Look at how red I'm going. Oh my God.
I already told Sue that Chelsea's moving. I think. I don't know quite how imminent it is, but I already told her that when Chelsea moves, then I can come down every once in a while. I'll be her like spare.
She keeps you in your trunk.
Jeepers. I miss my mom because she's my knitter friend.
Oh, that's so sweet.
So
aww.
I'll borrow Sue. I'll come visit because she's going to miss her daughter, and then we can just sort of, you know, have a moment.
That's cute.
I'll have to teach her how to drink some more tea.
Slam that tea back. You can do Tim Tam slams.
With tea, licorice tea, because I think Sue likes licorice.
That would
anywho.
Work. Speaking of the Tim Tam slams.
Oh my goodness.
So I was corrected in that I was supposed to shove it all in my mouth at the same time, and I just want to know how big you think my mouth actually is, because swear to God, it's not that big.
Those things are.
They are rather long, right? So.
That's what
anyways.
You said. You're just on a roll today.
You did that one. Oh my God. Oh, we're not adulting well today.
No.
We are teenagering very well.
Yeah. It's going really well.
Oh my God. Okay.
We'll have to have a
intervention. Okay. Knitting. That's what this is about. Wool. We love wool.
What have you been knitting this
week? We didn't do the thank yous. Pinfeathers and Purls.
Oh, yes, Candace.
That was really cute. I watched
so
the whole
nice.
Episode. It's always nice to see another Canadian, too. The accent, you could tell. As soon as I turned it on, I was like, she's from the
I
West.
Know.
And I was totally right.
And Yoshi.
Super cute.
I used to have a birdie.
Did you really? I didn't know that.
His name was Mark.
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 Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch?
No.
Totally. Don't believe her.
I have no idea why I named him Mark.
So
maybe
funny.
I have no idea. Probably after some.
Now I have that song stuck in my head.
Teen band. But then we went away on vacation.
Did he die?
No, he didn't die.
Oh.
He went crazy. He went nuts. He started picking his feathers out and getting really aggressive. Before that, he was really nice. Like, he would sit on the tip of my pencil when I would be doing my homework, which was kind of weird. And then.
I can't see you doing homework.
I did homework occasionally. And then if I would be sitting watching TV, he'd totally come out late, like a little baby, like in the crook of your arm, and you could pet his belly.
He missed you so much, he went crazy. Aw, that's too bad.
Poor Marky.
Anyways. Feathers and Curls. Check her out.
Thank
totally
you.
Cute. And she's a Harry Potter lover, so
yes,
we like that.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, else, we're good?
Jilly.
Yeah. I'm gonna
my best friend, Jilly. Sorry, you talk
she's
about
my
best
friend.
Friend. Jilly.
Well, that will go into my what's to be cast on my needle, so I'm going to touch on that.
We're going
to
wait on that one? Okay.
I'm going to wait a little bit.
So dye check. Christina sent me a picture of
my
her hands the other day.
My hands were great yesterday.
Oh, it was awesome, and I was like, sweet.
I posted it to Instagram. There's
did
photographic
you?
Evidence
okay.
on Instagram that my hands were very navy.
Mine?
I have a little.
I was doing socks or socks. Of course, I was doing socks. Pencil socks yesterday, so pink. And you can kind of tell I'm a little gray.
This whole hand is just like really.
You know why? Because I swooshed.
Color.
I really massaged the wool.
Massaged?
Because if I don't get in there, the pink doesn't get as nice. I'm trying to get it more even. I mean, I like the speckled kind of look, but I was really trying to get the pink more. So.
It's beautiful.
Yesterday it was even brighter because this was last night yesterday. So, and this is why I never have nice nails because.
Yep. I actually contemplated painting my nails because I'm...
Really? But then it stains the polish other than black. I once wore black nail polish that had like silver speckles and it was really pretty and it didn't dye it. So it was nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, yeah. I was dyeing Come Together and it uses a fat ton of navy and I had to mix up new dye stock so it's really concentrated and it splattered all over me and it got messy. But then... And with the dark navy, you got to rinse it a bajillion times afterwards. So then most of it kind of washed off.
Get some pink.
I had to use the heavy duty.
Centerpol. Yeah, that's the hardcore chemicals. That's
too.
That's no Kool-Aid dyeing right there, ladies. That's the full.
I don't want it to bleed on you guys, so I got to wash it out
bleeding
really good.
Bleeding is my worst nightmare.
Yes.
So.
All my navies have been washed like
a gazillion
two dozen times at least.
Really that many, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah. We have our dye off.
Yes.
To show you guys.
Our dye off project. So this was the picture we showed last week with the bird.
Yeah.
So this is mine, because...
Mine is...
Isn't this wet?
Wet, and it stripes. So look at these
and
beautiful colors.
Let's see here.
Look at those. They're actually showing up really well. Mm-hmm. This one's maybe a little bit more minter than it's showing, you think?
This one is a rather bright...
It's really nice.
Bright color. And then there's the teal, and this is like a raspberry pink, and then there's a blue, and this is purple tone, and this is the mini.
Love it.
That goes with it. So that's really cool. My interpretation.
And I did too, because I loved it so much, I thought, I wonder if I can recreate that to put it in the store. And I kind of did, although I changed it a bit the second time. So I did a mini, and I did the teal mini. I might have a thing for teal.
I might steal that yarn.
So this is, and it's hand painted, so it really shouldn't. So here we go. It has the beautiful kind of pinky purple into the teal with the blues on it. So that's that one. And then I did another one that's a little bit even more variegated. Like it doesn't have this little section of, but this one is just fantastic. I might have to dye myself one. Isn't that just beautiful? And it's got a little bit of black in it too.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta be honest, this was a watermelon gone wrong. Honest to God, it was. It was hot pink.
There were supposed to be four watermelons, people. Those sold out in 3 minutes instead of two.
Well, I had dyed five and one for, because I had a customer with a special order, so I thought I'm just gonna make a whole bunch.
Mm-hmm.
So I did five and this one went wrong. So I was like, what am I gonna do? So I threw it in, so this was pink, like watermelon pink, and then I threw it in with blue, which kind of started the purple, and then I threw in some turquoise, which gave you that. So I love it. I would totally make more of this.
That's beautiful.
So, oh look, you can see there's even some raspberries in there. I didn't even know. Ha! Look at that. So that's my interpretation. And we have decided, we talked about this morning, we are super close to 1,000 followers.
We are. We're 100 and, no.
Oh, less than that.
Shy of 100.
Yeah, like 90 or something. So we were thinking when we should do a giveaway for 1,000 subscribers. Yeah. Two people. So one of you will get my interpretation and the other one will get Christina's interpretation. So, if you have friends who might like us,
let them know
and subscribe so that we can get to 1,000 subscribers and we can give away wool. So we'll open a thread.
I'll open a thread on Ravelry, and there'll be a prompt. I don't know what it'll be. We'll have a prompt, just some fun to talk about. Maybe your favorite thing about the podcast. What do you enjoy most about the podcast?
I like that.
Because that gives us some good feedback on what, you know. Do we talk too little about knitting? Because that's what my husband said. He says, you know, you don't talk about knitting a whole lot. I'm like, well, we get off on tangents, but we could.
Me too. I feel a little poodly today. Speaking of tangents.
I had a poodle growing up.
So did I. I had a standard poodle. His name was Winston. Because he walked like Winston Churchill.
Mine was Pella.
Is that Danish or something?
There's a movie. I think it's Swedish. I can't remember. There's a very disturbing scene in there where somebody's manhood gets chopped off.
Oh my God! How old were you when you watched this?
I don't know.
And you named your dog? Or after?
I did not name the dog, and I don't know that the dog is named after the movie, but there's a character in the movie with the same name.
Speaking of naming animals.
Oh no.
On Instagram this week, I was challenged to the 10 things about me.
Yes, yes.
And one of them was
Let's hear this story.
My cat growing up, she, so she's a Cornish Rex. If you've ever seen a Cornish Rex, their fur, they only have like the bottom layer of fur. It's supposed to be like hypoallergenic and it's crimped. And I must have been maybe 8 when we got her, maybe a little younger. And I took one look at this cat and I was like, oh, her fur is kinky. Let's call her Kinky. And I swear to God, my parents, how could they let me do that? I don't know. Seriously, Kinky. Kinky! Oh my God. Oh my God. So I grew up into teenagehood. Like literally,
just imagining
as an adult,
you guys.
I had a cat named Kinky. What kind of parents were
so
the kids named
when it
Kinky?
Runs away?
Kinky,
then you guys just
Kinky.
What did the neighbors think?
And you know that meme that goes around like your prostitute name or your whatever your hooker name or something like that. Stripper name.
Stripper
is your animal name growing up and the street you lived on. So I'm like Kinky Pickering. That's my stripper name, Kinky Pickering. Oh my God. So that's how my cat was named Kinky, and I will never, ever live that down because I still had that cat when I met my husband. So you can imagine the grief a 16-year-old boy gave me for having a cat named Kinky.
Oh, that's what you get from meeting your husband so young.
There is that. So that, yeah, that's my story with Kinky.
Oy. Oh, gosh.
So what's next on this agenda?
I think we
my
should
schedule.
Do some whips.
Oh, well, I have a confession to make. I have not knit a single stitch this week because of my shoulder. I've literally nothing. But
did you go and get masseuse?
I got masseused. A very nice masseuse girl.
Yeah.
I really like her. I'm going back this week. The swelling's gone down. You can kind of see, like, especially my shirt sits here, the swelling right here.
Mm-hmm.
And so the end result is I also tore the trapezius muscle back there and my sternocleidomastoid. I don't know.
Funny word.
Yeah, so it's much better. I can lift my arm like this high. It snaps now, but I took a whole week off the gym. I haven't done that since October. But I went last night, and my brother-in-law hooked me up with some movements I could do, and it was good.
Yay.
It was good. Yeah, so, I don't know, it's going to take a while, because it's torn, right? So it takes
mm-hmm.
a while for the muscle to knit back together, but I'm hoping I can start knitting again
mm-hmm.
now. I'm going to try, because it's the squeezing of the arm, right? It's right here that hurts.
Right.
So, but I've got some whips, but they're exactly the same as last week.
Mm-hmm.
Socks for my girly. In Turtlepurl City Girl,
mm-hmm.
The finished sock is up here. So, you know, I've got more than a quo, I've got more than a ho, I've got a quo-ho.
Quo-ho.
By naming that. And then I have my husband's socks. He's never going to get these, but I did find waste yarn that I'm going to put in for after the hot heel. So I took one step in the right direction. So I literally need to knit this in and then keep going. So
mm-hmm.
next week I will have a hoe next week.
That would be exciting.
I will have a hoe. Because that's like, I need an afternoon. All I need to do
mm-hmm.
is an afternoon to finish that. So that's all I got. I got nothing.
I have nothing presently on a needle. But
Whoa, that's worse than mine. At least I got stuff on needles.
I have problems and I need help.
I can't even. You just left yourself right open on that one.
I know. So
notice me adulting. I am being an adult. Thank you. Hello. Right here. See, right here. Hello.
But I do have a whip because I've been working on my Vivid blanket and I made 4 squares this week. So I did this one.
That's actually impressive. Did you pick your new wool?
No, not yet.
Did you see which one I chose?
Yes.
I chose the bottom one.
I think that was my one too.
Of
so
course,
this was,
because
this
you and I are
the
same
color.
Person in different body.
And this one.
Oh, I like that one.
And this one.
Are you just rotating through all your skeins? Like you're not going to knit a whole skein?
Yeah.
I would knit a whole skein.
No. I'm rotating through. That's how I am. So this is my pile for this week.
Oh, can you see the
which
pile?
Which will now be added to the pile
bum,
of bum, previous
bum.
Ones.
Drum roll, please. We have a pile. Just throwing it
whoopsie.
At me now. We'll grab that one later.
Oh, go over there. Oh, behind me.
Yay!
Let's go behind there. So that was my whip. And
that's
I'm
good.
Counting those as 4 individual little tiny finished objects.
I think that counts.
And I cast it off.
That totally
I did
counts.
Not weave in the end, but I'm going to use the ends to sort of
yeah.
sew them together.
You and I have definitely, last week, established that we don't weave an end, so that does not make it a not finished project.
Actually, one of the pair of socks that I wore out, the ends were still not woven in.
I love it.
Who cares? I just
it.
Tucked them inside. Who cares?
Who cares?
My husband's socks that he has worn every day, they still have the ends hanging.
Doesn't matter. It's all good, baby. All
so,
good.
I am participating in Kristen's box of socks.
Oh, oh,
got
oh,
my
oh.
box right here.
Oh!
And I am also participating in, I want to participate in, rather.
What?
She has something she wants to say.
No, me?
Should
no.
Should I keep talking and let her burst, or should we let her say? What should
we? Look, I have a box!
Yeah.
I can eat a box of socks! Woo! Sorry. Oof, I need to say that so bad. Oh my god. Woo. Right there. Can you see it? I don't think I can
beautiful.
Reach.
I can reach it.
Christina, help me pick it out. Isn't it fun?
Because I needed to go to Michael's.
Dream big dreams. Cherish each day, but look, look, look. Laugh loudly. Game on, baby. And it's so much fun. Look, boom, boom. Oh, socks. Sexy.
Watermelon socks.
Oh, yeah, that's the original. So it's not the same color pink, but yeah, those are my watermelon socks. And have I shown these? I don't know if you guys have seen these. My rainbow toes. And then I've got my pencils. So this is my, so I put in a few of my current, of my 17 sock whips.
Just 17.
So I'm doing box of socks.
Yay!
Yay! All right, sorry. I can be mature now.
So I want to participate in Jilly's of the Knitting Broomstick. She's having a Harry Potter cowl this month.
Did you see her wand? I want a wand.
So I want to participate.
Okay.
Here's my problem.
Let's do it.
I had posted a picture on Instagram of yarn that I wanted to use either for Hermione's everyday socks or for the fine and dandy socks.
When did you post this?
A few days ago.
I don't remember seeing this.
And I love the yarn, but it's 100% merino, so I decided that should not be socks.
You know what? Only North Americans put nylon in their sock wools. Europeans, you should know this, knit straight wool socks, and they hold up just as fine as long as the twist is good.
But it's really nice yarn. It's pretty. I want to wear it up here.
You're a little off socks right now, aren't you? Because of your two.
No. I have three other skeins picked out. See?
Oh.
So now.
Hello, baby. What is this?
This is three Irish girls.
Should I tell them about what I know about them?
What do you know about them?
We have the same wool supplier. And you know how I know this? It's because I got one of their boxes.
Oh, yes.
And I only know this is because I had to peel the label with my name off and their name was underneath. And I was like, so, yeah, sorry. But I love their wool. So, yeah. So
this
one
here, I think this is from, they changed ownership, didn't they?
Yes.
I thought they did. Anyways, this one, I think, was from the original owners. But anyways,
I
love all the colors that are in it. So this is three Irish girls, adorned sock in the Love Wins colorway.
Oh, that's so pretty.
Then there is
Sparkle. Oh my God, the grocery girl. She's got sparkle wool.
This is Stelina.
And it's Tannis. I love Tannis.
Fiber Arts. And I love Tannis's yarn. And I love Tannis.
Where are we talking about socks here, lady?
And this is Ravine, which is on her Cosmic Blue label. It is 84% merino, 16% sparkling nylon. Option number two. Option number three is the Plucky Knitter.
This one. No, it should be that one.
No, it should not. This is a grown man, Make a Grown Man Cry in Plucky Feet.
You know what? If you start knitting this, your husband's going to steal it.
No, he's not. I won't let him. But it's, no, because it's going to be Hermione's everyday socks. Hermione's a girl. He will not wear it. He's funny.
So, I don't know, because I love the Irish girls, but Sparkle... As much as I love Plucky, it's my last place for me. These two, I'm going to have to go with this, actually. This will look so amazing, Hermione.
Will the pattern show?
Yeah, that's the whole point of Hermione's, is it's made with self-striping.
Will it pool?
Can I open this, or will you hurt me?
No, you can open it. Okay. Oh, will it pool? Because I don't like pooling on my socks.
I think that's the whole point of Hermione Everyday Socks, is that... Because you have that pattern helps the
pooling. Extract from it?
Look on Ravelry and look at other people's...
I should.
Really big skein, eh? Mm-hmm. Look at other people's and see how the pooling worked. Oh, isn't that pretty? Oh, beautiful.
Yeah.
They're definitely my colors. Don't you think? Thank God, wouldn't that make an amazing cowl?
See, I've already taken
the
other
skein to
be a cow.
So you're going to give that to me for a birthday?
No. Because this one is mine.
That looks amazing just like that.
That's a beautiful cow. You did that in no time.
Love it.
And there we go. She now has an FO.
I love it. That's wicked. Okay, so you're going to have to make your socks with the sparkly tannis because this is mine now.
There we go. Well, that just
solved the problem. That, didn't it? I'm the best friend ever. Look at me. I'm so selfless. I totally did that for you. It's
true.
All about Christina.
It's true.
Oh,
solve that
awesome.
Problem.
Yeah. Yeah. So speaking of new wool, something followed me home this week.
What followed you home?
You want to see?
Yes, I do.
Okay, so I was lucky enough to get to see this on Etsy because I follow, like, I like her shop. So this is Kaleidoscope Dye Works, and oh my god, look at that. Look at the speckles. There are so many colors. Mm-hmm. We have like this, I don't even know, like bright purple and greens. Oh, the green is like,
it's a lot of bright. It goes all the way from like neon.
Yeah, neon almost. To deep. Like it's a great gamut. And then there's so much lovely, like they're lovely natural wool. So this beauty is called Hawaiian Blue, and it's a sock wool. Like it's merino and nylon. And I was going to make a cowl with it, but you know what? Now that I'm doing box of socks, boom, baby. These
blueberry waffle socks
are going to be blueberry waffle socks, baby. Yes. Isn't that awesome? And she is so awesome. She sent me this too. Isn't this so pretty? So this one, she called it a gift from me to you. So that's really what we're going to go for. And this one is so pretty. It's not really showing. It has this really nice purple in it too. Mm-hmm. It's not just blue
this
and green.
This is like a lime green.
Yeah, it's totally my colors. So mm-hmm. I might have two Kaleidoscope Dye Work socks in my socks a box. Box of socks.
Socks a box.
Socks a box. Because it is so squishy. I don't know who her wool supplier is, but she's got a good one. Because it's a different twist than ours. We were looking at this before. It's yummy. But you know, yeah, because she's a 75-25, so we're 80-20, and it's beautiful. So thank you so much. I adore them. I cannot wait. It will literally be my next cast on. I might husband socks.
No, you only have till May 10th.
Really? Oh, right. Mm-hmm. You decided that.
I decided that because somebody's got to make the darn rules because you bend them.
But I have so much knitting time next weekend at the dance competition. Sure. Those will be done. Done and done. So these, when I'm done those, this will be my first cast on. Can you guys just look at this for one more minute? Because, oh my god!
It's beautiful.
You need this. I don't know if she's any left, though. But you need it. So you message her and be like,
I struck
Yarn Enabler out. Told me to go and buy this. You struck
I,
up what?
I struck out in the yarn purchasing acquisition department this week. Because I tried 2 or 3 different updates and completely struck out. I did not get any of the stuff that I wanted.
You know what?
I was not happy. Well,
and you're usually really good at stocking.
I usually am.
Like, she's got some mad skills. Mad skills.
We both got into the plucky shindig class and there was only 20 spots.
She says we, but she did all the work. I'm noticing a theme in our friendship. I'm the pretty one and you do the whole work, I'm kidding.
I'm the boss.
She's the boss. Oh my god, it's like what I was telling you about noticing my daughter. So she had this great play date on the weekend. And I was, we went out, I took the girls
Who
to the
had
movies.
The play date now?
We both did. Anyway, her friend is amazing. She's a really good kid, which is nice. And I'm watching them interact. And all of a sudden it was like light bulb moment. Because it was like the best friend was totally me, like personality wise. And then my daughter is complete Christina. Complete. And watching their interaction was like totally seeing us. And if you like look at our relationship from the outside, this is like what Pinfeathers and Purls were saying. It looks like I'm kind of like, wow, like I'm so out there and kind of like almost overwhelming. But in reality, she's the one in charge. I like totally just like orbit around her.
So make me twin A or twin B?
No, you're totally twin A.
Am I?
Yeah, you should totally. Yeah, you're too straight to be B. B is a squiggly one. So yes. So you struck out, but I didn't strike out because something else followed me.
Oh my. What is with this?
I know. So on Easter, Easter Sunday, I think, when we were here for dinner, Christina enabled me.
It wasn't hard. It's like, hey, look at this. It's pretty. You want it?
Yeah. So she showed me her project bag from Freckled Whimsy.
Yes.
And
I'm doing a swap with Freckled Whimsy.
Oh my god! Have you seen her bags? If not, go. Mm-hmm. Because they're amazing. So, I managed to snag this one in stock. And I love it.
It's so cute.
Isn't that awesome? And it's so huge because look at the size of the folds. I don't know the terminology for it. I know it's the bottom, but I'm sure there's some fancy name for it. Anyways. And it comes with this really great lanyard thing, which I love. And inside is it's pretty awesome too. So this has been in my purse now for a week because I think I literally got it Friday after last podcast.
Yeah, you got it.
And
really
it
fast.
Holds the husband socks and it holds the girly socks. All in the well, maybe not the needles today because I didn't do them neat. And I don't have a sleeve cozy Jody.
I know, I need a sleeve cozy.
I know. And look, boom. Done. Two socks in there. And it doesn't look like it's big enough, but it is. So totally.
I can't wait to get mine.
Freckled,
I'm really excited.
Whimsy. I know, I got mine before you. Mm-hmm. She likes me better. Freckled whimsy, people.
I'm sensing a theme here. It's a good thing that I have some besties here.
I know.
Like Sue and Jilly. You'll still love me, right?
Of course. Of course. So do you want to go next? Because I have this to show too.
Well, my other project that I was going to start. I'm kind of cheating a little bit because there's another cowl that I'm going to want to...
Another cowl?
Cowl.
I know, that's what I said.
Okay, I thought you said cowl.
Cowl.
Okay. Cowl. There's another cowl, and it's the GetLittKnit podcast.
Oh my god,
they're
I love
doing
them.
A cameo knit along.
Camarero.
And I wanted to knit this, and I have actually had the yarn in my possession for 2 years for what I wanted to knit with it. Now, theirs is a Hue Loco cameo cowl, so I'm kind of cheating because I don't have any Hue Loco yarn, and I don't think I would be able to get any in time. So I'm going to use this gorgeous raspberry color with slate
so
gray color for a cameo shawl.
Oh my god, that's gorgeous.
It's SweetGeorgia, CashLuxe Fine.
Oh my god, it's cashmere, guys.
And this is the slate colorway, and this one is raspberry. So there we go, raspberry and slate.
I remember you buying these. Didn't you buy these at the frolic?
We bought those when we went away on our getaway, where we snuck the crock pot.
Yes.
Into the hotel room.
I remember being at the frolic and helping you choose this one, and I never realized it would look so amazing right next to my face.
I can sense that my stash is going to twindle.
It's a good thing you have your stash hidden from me.
Actually, it's been boxed.
I know, because you're moving closer. Mm-hmm. Anyways, that one's gorgeous. It's going to be beautiful.
And when we move, there will not be this boring gray-blue color on my walls.
No, it's going to be bright. Have you thought about what color you're going to do your knitting area?
No, not yet. I've thought about what furniture I'm going to get for it.
Hell yeah. We're going to get some comfy knitting chairs. It's going to be fantastic. There. I like this. I'm sorry. I like it. I'm weird. Oh, so you want to see what I got?
Yes.
I've had this for a few weeks, but you guys need to see this. So if any of you out there are thinking about starting dyeing or are dyers, doodle stop. Dyer's notebook. Amazing. So I am not the most organized person, as we have already decided. And all of my colors are up here. I've maybe written a few down.
You haven't written any down? Mine have written down to like...
You have pictures of yours and freaking swatches and...
I do. Yeah. I have a picture of the yarn and then below is the exact recipe that I follow.
To you have these really cool pages that you can write a little picture and you can write down what colors you used and your formula, anything specific.
Mm-hmm.
Totally awesome.
That's really neat.
Yeah. And I've managed to keep it undyed, which probably won't last long.
Mine is messy.
So I really like it. So I bought it on Etsy because it's an a UK store. Mm-hmm. So there's their info on the back. But to get to Canada, I had to buy it on Etsy, and it came pretty quick. And I love it. It's cute, and it helps keep you organized. So I'm trying to be really good in writing down all my colorways.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. Yay me!
Yay!
Hey.
What else did we want to mention? The husband sock cowl. I think we should mention that there have been
so many people finished.
So many finished.
I thought
socks
you guys
posted.
Said your husband had big feet, but I'm seeing like someone's on their second pair.
Some people who have husbands with very small feet should maybe get a move on here.
I don't know who you're talking about.
I don't know either.
I don't know either.
It's just mystery person. But I went into the thread the other day and
love some of the colorways people are doing.
Mm-hmm.
Love them.
I try to make a list in post one of people who have indicated in the thread that they're going to participate. So you might have gotten an ear burn for that, and then you might have gotten a second ear burn if I saw a finished pair of socks in the thread. So if you have finished ones that you haven't posted yet, I'm going to post them.
Post them! You like your lists. I like lists too. Lists are good. We like lists.
I'm not really a list person. My husband is a list person. He has lists for everything and Excel sheets for everything.
Hi, Steven.
Oh, my goodness.
So let's talk sweaters. Because, okay, I guess we can do like a whole question segment. You want to do a question segment?
Okay.
So we were asked how you measure for your sweaters. And you know what? We're the perfect people to ask because we took a class.
We did. We took the Amy Herzog custom fit class. Actually, I took two of them.
Yeah.
The one we took together was amazing. Amazing.
Yeah. Seriously, like my brain just went... So I've knit myself two sweaters and I've knit all my kids' sweaters. So, I mean, I wasn't a sweater rookie. Like, I'm, speaking of which, this is my Lush.
It's beautiful.
It's made out of Malabrigo and it's my baby.
Mm-hmm.
I made this 2 years ago, actually. Facebook just reminded me. I finished it 2 years ago. Thank you, Facebook. And I love it. And it's, you know what? This wool, I've worn it so much and Malabrigo has stood up.
There's no pilling on it.
No pilling. And I've never shaved it. And it's, anyways, the only thing I wish I had done differently is I wish I had put buttons in. I didn't. So I usually keep it closed with a shawl pin, or right now it's actually a hairpin. Seriously, but it works. And I love it. But you know what? Three-quarter sleeves are good for when you're wearing it like inside, but I would like a bigger... The big cozy, I think, is a sweater that I bought a pattern for, and it takes like... You hold like bulky two strands, and it's like... It has this gorgeous cable going down the back.
That would be warm.
Yeah, and it goes down to like your mid thighs, so it's like a super huge.
That'd be heavy.
Yeah, but it's like a fall sweater, right?
Yeah.
So I want to knit that. That's on my schedule for maybe next year.
Yeah.
But yeah. So to do, I mean, obviously, take a course if you can, because that was really great. Read her book, I believe there's.
She's
numerous.
Got several books.
Yeah.
And on her website, she has a website. I think it's just customfit.com or something like that, but easy to find anyways.
Yeah.
And on there, you can actually go in and plop in your measurements and it will show you where to take them.
Yeah.
And then you knit your swatch and then you measure out your gauge and then you plop in that information and it will write the pattern for you. So you don't have to do your own math. Like, it'll do the math for you.
And if you don't want to do your website, she has an app. I don't know if it's for only Android, but I do have it on my iPhone.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Knit Tools. And what you do is you can open it. It has a buttonhole spacer calculator.
Mm-hmm.
It has a gauge widget. It has, this is my favorite part actually, is the, come on, my phone is not being good now.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, and then it has a decrease calculator for you. So you put in like, how many you want to decrease. So say you want to decrease 10 and you want to do it every fourth row. So it shows you how to do all of that. So it's, and it was only a few dollars, totally worth it in my opinion.
Yeah.
So I really like that. So it's, what did I call it? A knit tool is what it's called. But basically to summarize, the best tips we could give you is to measure, when it says measure your chest, it's right here.
Like your high bust.
Above your bust, in your armpits. And do it tight. Remember, she said, like, when you're measuring, don't, like, be loosey-goosey about it. Like, really get your skein of wool out of the way. Like, really do it tight. Because that will give you the best measurements. And then she said, pick
because
the...
Because if you... That's to be a bust size because that will correspond with your shoulder size the most. If you measure your true bust size... For some ladies, that there's too much difference.
Yeah, and then your shoulders are off.
Your shoulders are really floppy. And if you look at people who have nice fitting sweaters, it's because they fit on the shoulder.
And it's easy to modify the body than the shoulder. So her main tip was pick this pattern size for your shoulders and your bust and then modify for your body.
Yeah.
Which is easy if you get this knit tool calculator or use her website or buy a book so that has the formula in it. So pick the pattern for your shoulder size and your bust size, not for your waist size, which I did, and I did it wrong.
When you look at sweaters, most of the business is from your shoulders to your elbow almost, and then once you get down below, or not elbow, your armpit, when you get below your armpit, a lot of them are just straight stockinette, and you just need to put in your increases and decreases for your waist.
And really, I mean, a lot of us, that's where our shapes are different, right? Most of us have the same shoulder... Chest, I mean, obviously most of us have a bigger chest or a smaller chest, but you know what I mean.
And like, there's a lot of local yarn shops you can go. Some of them will have staff that are, I don't know if it's called certified, but know how the custom fit program works, and they'll be able to help you take your own measurements, because it's kind of tricky to do it on your own.
But I think the best thing we could say is go with her system.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
amazing.
That was really
informative. It totally changed me as a knitter. Mm-hmm. So, loved her.
So, what else do we have in,
wondered? No. Here, you want a funny story?
Oh, go for it.
So, you know our friend, the yarn therapist. She knits a lot because mm-hmm. of her job. She has the time. And she's just super fast, too.
Yes.
Her husband gets a lot of knit sweaters.
Oh, gosh.
Like, you know where I'm going with this one. So she knit him a sweater that had a shawl collar. He took one look at it and said, no, I can't wear that labia sweater. So now our whole knit group can't knit shawl collars because as soon as we see one, none's what we think of. So thanks so much, yarn therapist, for ruining a perfectly acceptable shawl collar for the rest of us. And now you guys! Technically it was her husband.
Technically it was her husband. Yeah. But he makes some really good food.
Oh my god, he is the smoke master.
Mm-hmm.
He's really good. Anyway, mm-hmm. so we can move off for sweaters now because now you know my secret. Every time I see a shawl collar, I'm like, oh no.
So
hey, you have a question.
I have a question. There's a couple of questions in our Have You Ever Wondered thread on Ravelry.
Mm-hmm.
One was from Megan, and she was asking about test knitting yarn because I had mentioned that this yarn for the shawl right there, I test knit it for Caterpillar Green, and she was wondering if it's normal for dyers to have the yarn test knit. For this particular yarn, it was because she does self-striping yarn primarily for socks, and then she came out with this new yarn that's meant to be for top-down shawls, and well, I guess you could do bottom-up too, but she was wanting a few different people to knit the yarn up to see how it would work out. So that's why she sort of had the yarn test knit. I don't think dyers typically test knit their yarn. A lot of people will knit up samples in their yarn to show off. And I've been a sample knitter for
way long time.
A long time.
Yeah.
Maybe about 5 years probably. So I've worked with a lot of yarn companies and a lot of designers, and so in that process, I'm basically test knitting the designer's pattern, and then often it's a sample for the yarn dyer.
Because a lot of time they work together. Like a designer and a dyer will work together to make a pattern for mm-hmm. a specific dyed new base or new mm-hmm. colorway.
Yeah.
Depends on who it is. Look, I got it back on.
But I think it's nice to have samples knit up of your different colorways because it's easier to... well, obviously you can see exactly how it's going to knit up. I try in my listings, I have like a little faux, like a little fake sock that I just did as a graphic.
Whose idea was that?
I don't know. Was it your sock? No, it was her idea.
Best friend ever.
And
but no, seriously, it sells for us as business owners. It sells.
Yeah.
I want to say faster, but the initial colorway is definitely more popular if you show it with a knitted section. And once, even if you haven't done that, though, once people start knitting with it, that's when people are like, oh, I love it. Yeah. And then you can see it better.
People like to know what it's going to look like once it's been knit.
Because we can look at a skein that we've dyed and know what it's going to look like.
Well, we know the stripe sequence and how wide the stripes are going to be and all this. But for the consumer's point of view, it's nice to have the samples knit up. So there's a lot of sample knitting that happens from a dyer's point of view. Probably not as much test knitting. More so maybe if they're getting a new base and they're a larger dyer.
They don't have time to do it themselves, right?
They will have people test knit it, but often they'll test knit their own yarn. So that was Megan's question.
Mm-hmm.
And then Christine asked us where to get yarn. So she is teaching kids to knit and was wondering how to get yarn. I think she's done Knit Picks, which honestly is a great place to start. If you're going to be teaching kids how to dye yarn, Knit Picks is really good value. They've got good yarn. They've got a great variety of different weights.
Shipping's not that expensive.
Different great makeups bases. Of yarn.
Yeah. Honestly, like, unless you're going to start ordering large quantities, and by that I mean like over 40 pounds of wool in one shot, Knit Picks, wool to dye for, those kind of...
There's a lot of different online places.
But I love Knit Picks wool. I think the bare wool is super gorgeous to work with. It's super soft and it comes really neatly packaged. And there's, I don't know, I really like their wool. I mean, it's not affordable when you're dyeing as much as we do, but if you're just dyeing with the kids, you're talking, what, $8, I think, per skein?
I can't remember.
Something like that. Totally doable. I mean, also, you could probably go to your local
craft store.
Like
Michael sometimes has, like, big blowouts on the yarn or good coupons, so you could use those to stock up. They will have blank yarn there as well, or white or neutral colored yarn. You can even dye stuff that has a color and then over dye it. Something else could be really fun. But for us, we get yarn from a mill. And there's minimum orders, and you know, there's certain...
Then you need a business number, like you need, so
they're not really accessible for,
no, sorry,
for just anyone, but
And
then, oh geez, all these for me. I guess that wasn't technically for me, but the next question is because Jane had asked, how did I meet my husband? So I am Danish, I grew up in Denmark, I lived in Denmark. My husband is Canadian and grew up here. We met
literally right here in the town that we both live in now.
Literally about 10 minutes away. And we met online. There is a program like...
Back in the day.
Because now everybody's like on Facebook or text messaging or whatever. But back in the day, there was a program called ICQ. And it was a little thing you would install. And then there was a button on it that says something like message random person.
Yeah.
That is how we met.
It's so
completely
random. Yeah, the universe spoke.
So that was a good 16 years ago.
And so then you guys talked online.
Mm-hmm.
And then what happened?
He came over to visit me.
He got on a plane to visit some random girl in Europe.
Because he's a farm boy. He sold a cow.
Sold a cow to fly to Denmark.
So he had the money to come and visit me. And then there's a good question here for Amanda, and that was Perry. She asked, what was the inspiration for your tornado socks?
Tornado colorway for my yarn box, which will soon be available in my store. Honestly, and you want like the honest answer, because I am nothing but laying it bare for you guys today. Holy cannoli. So I designed the sock first. And if you've seen the sock, it has like that twist. Well, it's not cables, but just the way it's, you know, that you have the ribbing looks like a tornado to me. And I just happened to knit it in that colorway. And I thought, oh, might as well call this talk winter tornado and the colorway tornado. Honestly, I had no idea. Being a Canadian, we don't really get tornadoes. At least nothing that would, I've never seen a tornado. There's never been a tornado anywhere near me. So I had no idea that that's actually the color
tornadoes. There has been one near me.
Really?
I went camping last
summer. Oh, right. Yeah.
And there was a tornado and it knocked over houses. I was scared.
Scary. Yeah. So I just
took everybody out of the trailer and made them sleep in the bathroom. Because I'm crazy.
Well, it's scary. We're not used to them. Like I wouldn't know what to do. Like obviously I would know, like go down to the basement, I guess, and stand in a door frame. I don't know. Like, yeah. So I am just that good that I got the colors for tornado by accident. There you go. You know what? All of the colorways, I worked with some of the people at Yarnbox to create them because they say, like, they let me know, because with Yarnbox, you get to choose, like, your most hated color, your most liked color. And so she gave me all that information, what people put the most, and orange. People hate orange. Mm-hmm. So we tried to stay away from orange, although it did get put in one colorway. And then she said, and then they have, like, when you select your Yarnbox, you do neutral, bright. Now I can't remember.
Neutral,
anyways.
Cool and warm?
Cool warm, yeah. So we tried to come up with colorways to kind of fit into each category. Mm-hmm. And I think Tornado was the neutral one, I think, if I remember correctly. And I love teal. Mm-hmm. I love turquoise. I love aqua. That whole area of the color wheel.
It looks like a tropical beach.
I love it. Yeah. Weather. So I just ended up, well, this is teal, but so it just happened. Mm-hmm. It's one of those colorways that just kind of created itself. And then the green on the end, I had no idea that would even make it more tornado-y. That was just a way for me to tell you guys that you're getting close to the middle, stop knitting, or put in a heel or something like that. Yeah. That was because when I knew I would be caking them up, and I wanted you guys to be able to know how much of half of a sock. So if it was just teal and then gray, you wouldn't know when you're halfway there. So mm-hmm. I literally dunked it in the green and thought, hey, that looks cool. And That's how I die. That looks cool. Let's throw that in there.
And here I am. I'm making graphs and all kinds of stuff before I even start. Before any color touches the yarn, there is a picture of what it should look like.
Exactly. Well, like, exactly. Like, for my die-off.
We are very different people.
But, like Candace from Pinfeathers and Purls says, that's what makes us fun. It's because we're so opposite that it plays well. So,
we also have to do another little shout-out for Jen.
Jen! Yay!
Amanda's bullying.
High five!
Cyber bullying paid off.
Yeah, okay. I was gonna say I resent that remark, but no, I resemble that remark. It worked though. She's got it up. It looks gorgeous. I have a cup here that I'm gonna knit it. I'm gonna have to dye something.
Her Americana jar cover has been published.
It's gorgeous.
We're going to try to put a picture here. So we got to make space so there's room for the picture.
Oh, neat.
It'll be right here.
Nice pictures, too. Your hubby did a good job. Does he have a tool belt? That's the question of the day. I know, right? Now everyone's thinking about husbands and tool belts. I've started a craze. And so when Home Depot sells out of tool belts and there's a whole bunch of babies in 9 months, it's thanks to me.
So the Toronto Knitters Frolic.
Ooh, we're going to have a podcaster meetup. Did I totally just steal your thunder? I'm sorry. I got really excited and it just...
That wasn't where I was going. But anywho, it's coming up at the end of the month and I will be there about all day because I have a class in the morning from 9 till 12 and then I'm going to be hitting the marketplace at around 12.
And I'm going to try and be there too. I have a previous engagement. My daughter has a dance recital, but it's in that area. And I will get the schedule 2 weeks before. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to do everything in my power to show up. I might have a little ballerina in tow with fake eyelashes, and then you'll know it's me. Mm-hmm. You know, because some loud redhead wandering around wouldn't be me anyways. So
there might be other
with the
ones.
Blonde sidekick. You think there's others? No,
I can think of someone else who'll be there, but I won't name names. But she's a dyer, indie dyer from Ontario. She will have a booth
with red hair.
She has a beige colorway.
Oh, Indigo Dragonfly?
Yes.
Oh my God, I love them. I will literally stand there for 20 minutes and just read all of the names. I will go through them all just to read what she's named them. And I had like a 5-minute conversation with her. Again, not knowing she was who she was.
It's my favorite trick.
You love introducing me to like famous people and not telling me they're famous or that they're involved with the product I'm looking at.
Yep.
And I just go on and on and on and on and talk about it. And then I turn around and she's like, do you know who that was? And I'm like...
I'm evil like that. But speaking of people who will be there.
Oh my God, I need one of these.
The lovely Catherine of Zigzag Stitches will be there so you can get your very own
telephone booth. I'm addicted to project bags
everywhere.
And I need one like that.
This goes with me everywhere. I love it.
Yeah.
But she will be there.
Show it again. Show it again.
So I'm going to stop by and say hi.
Yeah.
Yay. And
that has seen so many socks.
It has.
It has seen so many socks in so many places. Mm.
So
it's been to Denmark, people.
It has. And so at the Frolic, for those of you who are local to Toronto or within driving distance or crazy enough to travel up here, there is the marketplace, which is going to be phenomenal. There's a lot of really nice
really awesome.
Indie dyers there. But there is also going to be a podcaster meetup at 3:00 over by the cafe, as far as I've been informed. So this is being arranged by, I think she's a viewer of ours as well, Ramona.
Hi, Ramona.
And
did you just spill your tea? Because Jane said she spilled her tea when she heard her name on our podcast the other week. Now you heard it again, Jane.
Gosh, thank you.
Such a real educator.
So Ramona is part of the Toronto Knitters Guild, they arrange the Frolic. And she has been talking to Eric of Stitch Plus Twine to arrange for some sort of meetup. And currently it's scheduled for 3:00 over by the cafe. I'm going to try to be there. But I'll let you know if that changes. Amanda's going to be away next week, so we're recording a day early.
On Wednesday, yes.
On Wednesday.
So.
And then we also wanted to mention, if you're coming to the Frolic and you're placing an order with either one of us and you want to pick it up at the Frolic, we both set up coupon codes.
Same one, easy.
Same one, Frolic.
FROLIC.
So if you use that code, we will know to put it aside and bring it to the frolic. So I'll be there for sure. And if Amanda, for whatever reason, can't come, then I'll bring hers as well. So flag us down when you see us. I'm really quite excited for that.
Me too.
I would love to meet Eric. And I don't know if who else is going to be coming. I don't know if Penguin Sue might be coming.
No.
Or there is.
Oh, I love her.
Ooh, have you seen Knitting at Tiffany's? It's
no.
also a Canadian podcast from Ontario.
Really? Is she going to be there?
I don't know.
I'm going to be watching her podcast this afternoon while I stuff pencils.
But there's still another like 3 episodes to go. So if anything changes timing wise,
we'll let you know
mm-hmm. and when and where to find us.
Sounds good.
Mm-hmm.
Yay. So that's our little frolic
mm-hmm.
thing. And then I was going to say, I was asked on Instagram again about my
Notions bag,
and I've discovered Christina doesn't have one.
I don't have one, and I love this fabric. I love it.
I know, isn't it great? So that's my foxy gentleman, and I do a colorway every once in a while.
Was this So You Say? Shauna, did she make this for you?
Shauna, So You Say made that for me.
I'm going to need
She's
one,
awesome.
Shauna, and I know...
I don't know if she has any more fabric.
I don't know if she watches. I know Jen watches, and she was doing a repeat yesterday.
She was watching
a marathon yesterday. So
yeah. And then she kept messaging us because we have a group message on Facebook, and she'd like comment on like, so I always knew what episode she was on.
Yeah.
She'd be like, you guys. So wait until she sees this one.
Call her.
She's going to show Dan. Oh my gosh, she's going to show him. That's
we
awesome.
Totally told her that we talk about her all the time. So
we do.
There was fair warning.
Fair warning. Yeah, so this is my Notions bag. So this stays in my purse. This stays in my purse, and this is my last one that stays in the purse that has all my lip gloss because I'm addicted to lip gloss. I love it. Anyway, so in my Notions bag, I have a little tin. And in my tin, I have my row counter for when I'm doing lace shawls. I have my color work guide, which you actually showed me.
Thing.
Yeah.
It's like $1 at Knitpicks.
It's awesome.
It is so cheap.
Yep. I've got my little scissors.
I need a pair of those.
They're awesome. You know what? They cut through like friggin' bulky. Like they're awesome.
I need them.
And they have the little cover. I've got my, actually I need to use these, my tips again from Knitpicks.
Oh yeah.
Because for my Addies, those things are so sharp. I need to tip those bad boys.
You know, that's one thing I'm going to get at the frolic is the Hiya sharp. So I want to try Hiya.
Oh fun. I think I should get some too. Every knitter has like a gazillion of these.
I have lost about 10 of those.
Well, I know, but they're so cheap to buy more. Mm. That's the problem. And I have plastic ones that are bigger and then metal ones that are finer. Mm. And then, I mean, everybody who has interchangeables has the little tightening key. Mm-hmm. And then I always keep 2 of the stoppers mm-hmm. just in case. And then what else do I have in here? I'll just dump it on our show notes.
Sure.
Ooh. Oh my God. Everybody needs one of these. This is a tiny crochet hook with a straight end. And when you drop stitches, you need this. This will save your life.
And you have 2.
Of course
you
I have 2.
You had 2.
Have you? You know about my whole fear of drop stitches. Of course I have 2. Oh my God, I'm scared of them. So I also have my little Kitchener cheat sheet. Yeah. This is from Burning Impressions 2. I have more stuff coming from her too. And I knit toe-up socks, but when I need to do Kitchener Stitch, I want Kitchener Stitch over 300 stitches together. That cowl?
These!
Isn't that great?
I know!
Okay, so I have these little tags, and you can't really see, but they have, like, numbers and millimeters on them, so this is...
They're off the Knitter's Pride
Yeah,
set.
So this is for my interchangeable needles. When I take the needles, because I do that frequently, and then leave the cord on, I make sure I put a tag on to remind myself what size the needle was.
Good idea.
Yeah, and then, of course, every knitter, you need a tape measure. Mm-hmm. I have a Knit Happy one. I love Knit Happy stuff. I have their mug and cabling needle. I've had a few different kind of cabling needles. I've had the straight wood ones with the notches in it.
Mm-hmm.
Don't love them.
Yeah, not a fan.
I like this. I sometimes just use, like, a DPN.
Yeah, that's me.
But then I always stick it in my ponytail. But you know what I've done? So while I was cabling once, and I was using just like a short TPN, sometimes I like to stick it right here in my cleavage, which I'm told I have to cover up for the podcast. Psh, I stuck it there, and then I literally went and picked up my kids with a needle sticking out of my boobs from school. I was walking around like this. I am awesome.
Poor husband.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, and inside, so this is what Christina says she loved.
This is really cool.
You know what this is? This is the little bag that came with my Kalo ring. So these are a special There, it's a silicone ring. Boop, boop, boop. I wear it because when I CrossFit, I can't wear my rings to do weightlifting and stuff. And because I'm at CrossFit like 4 times a week, and my wedding ring is actually too big for me now. Yay! And it was falling off. So I needed a ring that wasn't expensive that I could wear. So it came in this little bag.
That's really cool.
So I keep this because the bag is awesome.
Did your husband get one of them rings too? Did he get a little pouch?
He got a little pouch. He doesn't use it. You want it?
Yes, I do.
Okay, I'll give it to you. I have a cozy knitters. Stitch markers.
They're not in production.
You should email her and ask her for a special order of them.
Oh, gosh. Oh, man. You're going to come help me.
You know what? Oh, I don't have my pencils. I have the pencil stitch markers too, and they're super cute. And you should tell her to make some, because then I will give you a discount on a pencil skein of wool if she makes the pencil stitch markers.
This is quite the deal.
Pressure. And then a pen. Is that my pen or is that your pen?
No, my pen. That's my pen.
Okay, well, I don't have anything else then. I usually have a pen in here, but I stole it for something else. Anyway, so that's what's in my Notions bag. I am prepared. I'm prepared for color work. I am prepared for cabling. I am prepared for dropping stitches. I'm prepared for stealing needles. I am, you name it.
You're covered.
I'm covered.
I've got it all. I have a Notions pouch.
You should, because you know what? I love knowing where all my little doodads are. And I have copies of these. Like, you know how I talk about my needle drawer? I have a needle drawer where most of them live. I have literally a copy of every single one of these that lives in the drawer. Like, Christina has drawers here behind us. But then, because if I only had one, I would forget it in the house, or I would forget it in my purse, or I need two. I need two of everything. It's like in my house, I have scissors everywhere because I lose scissors.
I have like 20 pairs of scissors. Do you think I can find a single pair?
But don't they have houses?
My children steal them and hide them. Oh. I have one son who is obsessed with boxes. Obsessed. He just has to like play in the box. Every time I get a box of yarn, he steals the box and then he cuts holes in it and it becomes some sort of spaceship or airplane or rocket or whatever.
You need to
buy
him his own scissors.
But he has his own. But he keeps stealing mine because he knows my scissors are kept in the kitchen drawer. So he just goes there, takes mine, and then he doesn't.
Well, that's why I have to have a gazillion
pairs.
Sometimes
he gives himself haircuts. He has, like, a chunk missing.
One, two, three. Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Oh, you have new stuff.
I have something new to show you guys, and it's not part of our die-off. It's a self-striping, and it came to me in a dream.
Hmm.
2 days ago, I woke up, and this colorway was in my head, and I literally went downstairs and wound it and dyed it within, like, half an hour. And it's not as pretty as in this skein as I would have hoped. I wanted it to sample, but here it is. It's called Lemonade, and it will have a yellow stripe, a white stripe, a pink lemonade stripe, and another white stripe. And it's so pretty, and it just makes me feel happy, and it's summery.
You gotta do the yarn face, Mina's yarn face.
Oh, with another one?
Hi,
Mina.
This is gonna be your picture.
Anyway, so this will be going up in the shop today, so you guys will see this podcast tomorrow, so it will be up in the shop, and I just think it's so, so cute, and
Speaking of in the shop, some of these babies are going to go up in the shop, too.
Yep.
Our yarn-off one.
Our yarn-offs.
Whoa!
Our yarn-offs will be in
they
the shop.
They will be clean, I promise.
They will be in the shop.
Yes.
I have this color mini. Our minis are actually different colors, which I think is amazing how they're so different.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, we'll each have new stuff in the shop today.
Yeah. I don't have... This is...
Oh, Mina's face.
The yarn off. Mine is going to be called Bye Bye Birdster.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. There's a sad story.
Oh. Mark again?
No.
Not Mark.
Not my
Mark's
bird this time. So, actually, the bird story continues. My father loves birds and parrots. And
really?
We had a whole lot of them at my house. Like, it was, we had a separate room built off the garage.
An aviary?
Yes. With.
Are you impressed I knew that word? Totally
lots
impressed.
Lots of birds. And we had, like, these big-ass parrots, big green things.
Big
and then we had a lot of love.
Parrots.
Yep. We had a lot of love birds.
What do you feed parrots?
Parrot food. And then when my husband came over, because we used to live in Europe in the summer. between semesters. So in the summer, we live in Europe, and he got to pick one of these lovebirds.
No way.
And he named it Birdster. And they were, like, really close.
With Mark?
No, Mark was gone by this time.
Oh.
But really close. And then when we moved here, oh, Birdster stayed behind.
Oh.
And it gets worse.
Oh, no!
My mother was...
Did she bake him?
No, she went away on vacation or something.
Oh,
anyways,
no.
The neighbor was babysitting the bird.
Uh-oh.
Bird sitting.
Uh-oh. The window was open. Oh, no! Oh, no, so he didn't just die. He...
Bye-bye, Birdster. He's not dead. He's out there somewhere.
So you named it Bye-bye, Birdster.
Bye-bye, Birdster.
I don't know. I don't even know how to react right now. I'm
very sad. My husband gets very, very upset about
it. So you named it Colorway after one of his most traumatizing
It was his idea. It was his idea. Because in the picture, it kind of looks like
cojones.
That thing did not like me. It tried to pull his wedding ring off. Like,
awesome.
He would be sitting at the computer and the bird would be on his shoulder and it would, like, walk over across the back of him and then down his arm and, like, yank on his wedding ring.
Aww.
But it would be sitting on his shoulder, like, nibbling his ear and, like, all lovey-dovey. Yeah.
That's
it was
funny.
Not cool with the whole marriage. Nope. Bye-bye, Birdster.
I can't follow that
What's
up.
What's yours called?
I win.
Here we go with the selflessness, huh?
I'm just kidding. I don't know what I'm going to call it. It's not going to be Bye-Bye Birdster, though. I don't know. What should I name it?
I don't know. Come up with something brilliant.
No, I won't. I suck at naming. How about, Yarn Squish?
The Squishy?
The Squishy? I don't know. Well, you'll have to just look at my shop.
Tune in
next week. Find it. I don't know. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I've already have a paradise colorway.
Bird of paradise.
Bird. Maybe just bird. Bird.
Pretty bird.
Pretty bird. We're losing it now.
We are losing it.
Okay,
we better
go. We should stop now.
We need lunch.
Subway today.
So,
I think
thank you everybody for joining us for another week. We truly appreciate it. And see you next week.
Happy knitting. Have a good week. Bye, guys.
Bye.